as UM celebrates its 75th year as one of the leading higher academic institutions in Southern Mindanao. Let's look back on how far the university has gone and maybe even get a glimpse of how further we can go in the next 75 years and more. Wonder how the largest private non-sectarian university in Mindanao developed over the years? UM's journey is nothing short of epic, and it started with our founder, Attorney Guillermo E. Torres, acquiring the lands from the Japanese where UM Bolton and the UM Embassy campus now stand. He had to work fast to acquire it because after World War II in Davao City, a lot of businessmen had their eyes on the properties as it was strategically located in Davao's fast-rising downtown commercial center. But because of Attorney Torres' advocacy to make education available to more Mindanaoans, he was assigned legal ownership of the property and the first one-story building, which housed the dean's offices, admissions office, laboratory, library, and some classrooms were quickly constructed in time for the 1947 to 1948 school year. Expansion was rapid as the UM Technical School was then established in 1949, followed by branch campuses in neighboring provinces of Davao City, as Attorney Torres felt it was limiting to concentrate school operations in Davao. Between 1950 to 1962, branch campuses were built and operated in Ligos, Peña Plata, Tagum, Gianga, Tibungko, Panabo, Cotabato, and Pansalan. The lush and expansive Matina campus grounds, meanwhile, were acquired towards the end of the 70s and development started in the early 80s. It houses much of UM's colleges now, except for the College of Business Administration Education and College of Legal Education, which are situated in UM Bolton. The most recent jewel in UM's roster of facilities is the grounds housing the 400-meter rubberized oval track, which is also used for other sports and games like running broad jump, shot put, and soccer. This enabled UM to serve as the host for the opening ceremonies of the 2019 Palarong Pambansa. Only time can truly tell of the innovations that UM can come up with, and all will be for the advancement of education of the Filipino.